that's me right there in the ball and hot sun in the summertime. You know, working like a, that's really me, working like a mind of clay. You see that pretty little girl right there? She came out there, she was only 4 years old at the time, working with, you know, with different folks and stuff. And we started out with nothing but dirt, got to be this right here. And then you see what you see right here, you know, and what we do, we pulled about 1,500 pounds of produce and watermelons and all that other good stuff out. We share it with, you know, all these community service organizations like Crisis Control Ministry, American Soup Kitchen, church food banks, and different places like that. And we also share with the folks who come to volunteer with us. You might want to take home some college, you know what I mean? I know y'all in college, okay, and broccoli and different kinds of things like that, because what we found out was that this general area is a drought area for fresh produce, okay? And we're making a difference, we're making an impact, because not only able to provide people with good food, and good healthy food, not fast, but good healthy food, you know what I mean? So, if you're interested, okay? And we work on Wednesdays from 5:30 to 7:30 p.m. and on Saturday mornings from 9 a.m. until 11 a.m.
Free cake, people.
You can make it any time.
I'll
put you on our mailing list. That is the email list of, you know, if you want us to call, whatever the case may be, whichever the best way to contact you. But we look, the main thing is we're trying to make this a student-driven initiative. We got it started, but we believe that you know, this would be a benefit not only to the students, but to the people in the community who don't know the students and do not know them. And the kind of good it comes through and trying to bring everybody together, the faculty, staff, students, and the community on something that is helping the community and doing something that's good.
What's up, Taylor?
You're around.
What about free salmon?
That's what we're looking for. We'll provide you the hose and the gloves to wear and different things like that. You know, what you don't know about the garden or whatever, you'll learn. If you have people there, you know what to do. I'll show you. I'll tell you that right now. I would have known the difference between an eggplant and a grapefruit. So, I mean, you know, it's pretty simple, but that was me. You know, but I know a whole lot more about me. And that's what you want. Okay, so. We appreciate it. We appreciate it. This is your senior year?
No, this is our freshman year.
It's your freshman year, okay. Well, then we can work together, then we got things to do. We got watermelon, we got cantaloupe, we got zucchini, we put a zucchini. Where's that zucchini?
I didn't bring it.
We should have brought that. That thing is about that long.
It's like a baseball
bat. I'm like, oh my God, buttermilk squash, eggplant, peppers, tomatoes of all description, hot, you know, like, okay, we got plenty for you, okay? So most of it we donate to these various community agencies. We just need some more student involvement. Y'all gonna help us? Okay? Sign up, right? All right, Rudy Anderson is my name. I'm glad to meet you. Hope to see you soon. Come to the garden and help us out. Thank you. Of course, and we contribute to, you know, various community charities like Tulare Soup Kitchen, Sunnyside Ministries that you see right over here. Crisis Control Ministries for people who don't pay. You know, this gives us an opportunity to help people who don't have. And all we need is for you to come by, pay attention to it, sign up right here, so that you can be on our mailing list to let you know when we are actually doing things out in the garden. Okay? That's all we need. Yes, ma'am. That's what I figured. Okay, here we go. So if you would, I'd appreciate it. Okay? Thank you very much. Thank you very much. That's watermelon, that's buttermilk squash.
Yeah, I know what it is.
Oh, you do?
My grandma has this in her backyard. I know what it is.
Oh, yeah? Yes. Did you help her pick some of that?
I help her pick it. I don't plant it.
Okay, okay.
I don't plant it. Well, then you can do it. Okay. Patent, but I'll pick it.
You can. Well, now, if you can just do that, we much appreciate it. Okay.
Okay.
So
our
if you okay. Okay. Don't worry about it. Just put it down there so that when we send the email out, we need your help. This is what we get. Okay.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Thank you ever so very very much. Okay.
Yeah,
did you know this? Check that out right there. Did you know that?
Oh, no.
Did you? Yeah. See, another reason to pay attention. According to the Food Hardship in America 2010 report, Winston-Salem ranks third in the country for the highest rate of food insecurity. That is, children don't know where they're going to get their next meal. You know, and that's, don't worry about it. It's not next week. That's not cool. You know? So we got to do more. We got to do more to help them. And see, this project is a way to help. Which is a state community, staff, faculty, students, everybody get together, as well as the community at large to get together with us to do something good for the entire community. Okay? All right. Thank you, ladies. Thank you so very, very much. We look forward to, you know, having you with us when we get ready to harvest. Okay? All right. We appreciate it. Thank you so much. All right. You do the same, ladies. You do the same. Thank you. All right.
Do